Today, body art and tattooing is practiced all over the world. Different cultures, religions, and districts are all using their own kind of body art for their personal reasons or just for the beauty. So how did it start? And how come such a religious and spiritual practice has been changed to be used for other things, such as beauty?
Body art started is that someone had a small wound and rubbed it with their hand that was dirty with soot and ashes from the fire. Once the wound had healed, they saw that the mark stayed permanently. Many theories have been conducted on how the body art and tattooing was discovered. Today, we will be talking about body painting and tattoos in places such as Mesopotamia, Egypt, Greece, and Rome, in the modern world.
Over time, humanity has developed many uses of body art. So far, it has been used for symbols of rights, symbols of rank, symbols of spirituality, devotion, religion, rewards and awarded for bravery, amulets, talismans, security, beauty, war, and prisoners. The practice in the Middle East of people cutting themselves and rubbing ash has been during a period of mourning after an individual had died. It was a sign of respect for the dead. People were carrying with them a reminder of the individual, and this was because after rubbing the ash from the soil of the burial into a wound, it had created a tattoo. For the native Hebrews, the practice of body art, cutting your flesh, or print any marks upon you was not allowed. This was stated in the Old Testament.
Egyptians had spread the practice of tattooing throughout the world. Tattoos in Egypt can be found as early as before the pyramids were made. By 2000 BC, the art of tattooing had stretched out all the way to Southeast Asia. From the Ainu, who were the Western Asian nomads, brought it to them as they moved to Japan. There is evidence of bodies dating as early as the 11th dynasty with tattoo patterns on them. One type of pattern or design that they had practiced was the art of grouping dots and dashes that were aligned into abstract geometrical figures. However, this form was restricted to women only, usually were associated with rituals.
The Greeks had learned the art of tattooing from the Persians. They'd used tattoos to transmit messages between their spies. It was also practiced to indicate slavery. The Romans had inherited the art of tattooing from the Greeks. It was recorded that in the early Roman Empire, all slaves exported to Asia were tattooed with the word tax paid. Many slaves and criminals had been tattooed to show their rank. Tattooing on the face had been common for convicts, soldiers, and gladiators. When Constantine had become the Roman Emperor, he banned the practice of tattooing on the face. He had believed that the human face was a representation of the image of God and should not be disfigured. Indians have used the human body for centuries for their art. Many of the art forms are the Nama, which are the daily body paintings, the Viputi, the sacred ash, the Mangalya, the red dot worn by Indian women, and Henna. Body painting in India has been used to devote themselves to the gods, rituals, celebrations, and symbolism. Henna has been used since the late Bronze Age. It has been used to decorate the body for important occasions and celebrations. In the north and the west of India, mehendi is an important part of the wedding ceremony. It is believed that the deeper the color of change on the skin, the longer the love between the couple will last. Today, you may not even know it, but body painting is used all over the Western world. Makeup. Makeup is used in the theater, which helps actors take on new identities and such.
In the West, the electric tattoo machine has revolutionized tattooing.
Many of body art cultures that we have stated are still being used today throughout the modern world. People have kept their traditional work of art and still use it for the same reasons that they did thousands of years ago.
आजा जिंदे शामी आने के तले आजा जरी वाले नीले आसमाने के तले आजा आजा जिंदे शामी आने के तले है आजा